I've had three incidents where my face piece grazed once it bubbled. The incidents were in a controlled burn twice and then an actual structure of fire once.
If firefighters get into a thermal environment that can cause damage to the faceplate of the respirator, it can cause either crazing, which is like a bubbling effect that limits visibility, or in extreme cases, it can actually melt. Burn Saver is a device that was developed to give first responders a warning when they're in a thermal environment that can cause degradation to their personal protective equipment, specifically the face piece of their self-contained breathing apparatus. The Burn Saver device has five thermal sensors. There's a software inside the Burn Saver that compares thermal profiles against possible threat levels. So basically, when a firefighter enters a thermal environment, it's comparing the outside temperature that the sensors record with the internal database that's contained in the software.
Given how conditions can sometimes change rapidly, sometimes where our activities take our focus away and distract us, having something that can continuously pay attention to the conditions and alert us to any dangerous conditions that are coming up is very important.
When Burn Saver detects a temperature that can cause problems with the integrity of the face piece, it can alert in three different ways. One is a blinking or a steady blue light. The other is an indication through a radio channel back to command post. Or the third is an indication in the firefighter's heads-up display contained in his self-contained breathing apparatus mask.
I can see on a monitor what the temperatures of firefighters are being exposed to versus just relying on what is happening with the outside of the structure.
We conducted a field assessment of the Burn Saver at the National Fire Academy. What we wanted to know was if it was going to interfere with the normal activities that a firefighter had to perform. The general impression by our evaluators was very positive. They made some recommendations to make some fine tuning to make the alarm more visible, but overall they liked the concept and they thought it'd be something very worthwhile.
This technology absolutely does address something that's important to us. As our PPE improves and gets more and more advanced, we're able to spend more time in hotter conditions, and the weakest part of our ensemble is the face piece. So having this technology to help us prevent that failure is very important.